Good evening, everyone present here. My name is Karthikey, studying in 9th standard, and today I'm going to present the topic matter and our surroundings. Contents of this presentation: what is matter, characteristics of particles of matter. Particles of matter have spaces in between them. Particles attract each other, physical properties of matter. So what is a matter? A matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. Pen, paper, clips, sand, air, ice, etc. are different forms of matter. Every matter is made up of tiny particles. These particles are so tiny that they can't be seen with the naked eyes. Let's learn about a different characteristics of particles of matter. Now there are three states of matter, that is solid state, liquid state and gaseous state. Characteristics of particles of matter. Every substance is made up of particles. These particles exhibit some characteristics. They can influence the state and properties, physical and chemical, of they can influence the state and properties of the substance. There are four main characteristics of a particles of matter. Particles of matter are very tiny in size. They have spaces between them. Particles of matter move constantly. They are attracted towards each other. Particles of matter have space in between them. Intermolecular space is term used to describe the space between the matter particles. Depending on the kind of matter being considered, there may be certain amount of intermolecular spaces between the particles of matter. The intermolecular space between the particles of particles is greatest in gases and lowest in solids. Particles attract each other. In every substance, there is an inter-particle force of attraction acting between its particles. To break something, we need to overcome this force. The strength of this force differs from one substance to another. The inter-particle force of attraction and the kinetic energy of the particles primarily determine the physical state of any matter. Solids have the highest force of attraction in inter-particles, and liquids are medium and gases are the lowest. Properties of matter. Are these properties determined without changing the identity of the substance? If no, chemical properties. Does the matter reacts in the presence of these things? That is air, acid, base, water and other chemicals. If yes, physical properties. Does properties depend upon the amount of substance? Yeah, if yes, it's extensive physical property, mass, volume and shape. If no, then intensive physical property, that is color, melting point, boiling point or density. As you have seen in the fourth slide, matter is made up of tiny particles called atoms and can be represented or explained as something that takes up space. It must display both the mass and volume properties. Properties are the characteristics that enable us to differentiate one material from another. A physical property is an attribute of matter that is independent of its chemical composition. Density, color, hardness, melting and boiling points and electrical conductivity are all examples of physical properties. And now I would like to explain the structure of solids. That is, solids are particles of solid arranged in this way. So intermolecular space in solids is like this. There's no space or it's very small. And in liquids it's medium or medium. And in gases it's very large. So this is the relation between intermolecular space with your solid. Intermolecular space of three states of matter. Solids are the least, gases, liquids are medium, and gases are the highest. And thank you.